connections. Now we start with connections. It's our last topic in this course. And we start with welded connections. Two types of connections, welded and bolted connections. And all of this we are dealing with this course in something called simple connections. Simple connections. It means we are not considering the effect of bending. If there is bending, we are not dealing with this one. Usually this is covered in advanced course. So we are dealing with simple connections using the welded connections or the bolted connections. So welding, when you weld, you are fused two materials and join them into one material. And you are joining two materials into one material by kind of melting them and make sure they bond together. Okay? And that shield, usually we have shield, metal, arc, weld, shield, SMAC, shield, metal, arc, weld. Why? Because you want some kind of shielding gas to prevent air from going into the weld. If the air is trapped into the weld, the air goes into the weld, you have something called cavity. And with these cavities you have problem. You have a stress concentration, huge stress concentration, then you have a potential failure. So always when we weld, you have to have a special or a skilled worker to do the welding. He must be professional, skilled, with experience. Yeah, and those builders sometimes they are paid more than the engineer. They are paid like $35 or $25 per hour to do the welding. And if he's there, yeah, the most important thing is about safety. When they weld, they go over, they have to be tied, marbutin, and rocks so that they don't fall. There's a lot of concerns, okay? There's a lot of safety issues. So when he's there, and he's welding at one place, make sure he finish all welding. Make sure he do everything. You don't want him to go back to that place and do a new welding, if you want to weld. So again, there's two things we need to take care of in terms of how we conduct the welding. You are not going to be a welder, you're going to be an engineer. But if you are asked how to do the welding or evaluate the welding, two things. It must be there is no entrap of gases or material. And the other thing, you don't want the welder to change the metallurgy, the material properties of the base metal or the member. If he changed the metallurgy, if he changed the material the steel may become brittle instead of or weak. Weak or brittle, you know, when we design steel members, they are supposed to be ductile members. So these are the two important things when they do welding. They calculate, they do some calculation on the material of the welder or the electrode or the deposit, okay? So that they don't, you should not stop too much. You should not apply too much fire. Okay, so you don't change the metallurgy of the base metal or the member. Okay? And usually there is some kind of slag. When you finish welding, there's a slag on the top layer. Okay, slag. This is the deposit, one of the deposits of the welding thing. So you are joining two materials together. Something called the most important welding practice, something called fillet weld. Fillet weld is the one that we're gonna learn how we design the length of the weld. How we design the length. When we design the weld, it's how much the length. What is the length of the required length of the weld? And what is the configuration? Should I open both sides? Should I weld all around? Should I weld on the two parallel sides? Remember, this affects what? Affect the U factor in tension members. Affect the U factor in tension members. Okay? Good? So, this is the design. So that's why usually there's grades for the welding material. And in the welding material, you can have expensive material or not expensive. You can have some material, the welding material, with 70 psi strength, or 60 psi strength, or 80 psi strength. Okay? So this we will select. Usually the most common material used in weld is the 70 psi material, called E70XX. That's the designation for the welding material. E70 or E80. So we know that. Now we calculate the strength of this weld pair. Inch. And each inch of welding, if I weld 1 inch, spot 1 inch, how much the strength to break it? So that's why I calculate per inch. I have the load that needs to be transferred with the weld. I divide the load by the strength of per inch. I calculate how many inches I need. And you may need 10 inch, 15 inch. 20 inch. Then you distribute them. It's up to you. Kilo wallah ya put side of 10 if you want 20. Or you tell him this side look like make sure you weld the transverse side of the member, and if you remember it's 8 inch, it's an angle, that's 8 or 8 inch. That's 8. If you have 20, then 12 remaining, 6 from here and 6 from here. Okay? There's some limitation. What's the thickness of the weld? What's the minimum thickness you can weld? What's the maximum thickness you can weld? This is a function of the member you are welding. Yeah. If you are welding something very thick, you cannot weld that thing with a small thin element. It doesn't provide the necessary jointing or restraining of that member. Or if you are welding a thin material, a thin section, you cannot just weld with like 1 inch or 2 inch, something much bigger than that. Okay? So there is, it is a function of the thinner element and the thickest element. This will determine what's A minimum. A is the size or the thickness of that weld. Okay? This is what we will study. And where to stop the weld? Can we stop at the end? Or should we stop before the end? Or if we go to the end, should we turn it around? All of this geometric limitation we will cover. They are provided by the code. And the design, as I told you, is based on the load. Our intention is to create a weld that's stronger than the connected element, so that the weld doesn't control the design of the element. Okay. This is how we define, or this is how we look at the weld. This is the size. This is the size. You may have half inch, 3/16, 3/8 of an inch, 3/4 of an inch. This is the size of that weld. This is how we weld. And we only take this here. It's like a 45 degree triangle. 45 and 45. This is, they call it the throat of that weld. Why? Because when they do testing on the weld, this is how it's made. It breaks along this plane. See, this one here is this. If you test it and evaluate its strength, and if you test a piece of wood in the lab, this is how it's going to break. It shears like this from the middle. So always when we evaluate the strength of something, we break it, we see how did it break, it in kasrat, then we say, okay, what's the material that was part of that failure? You have this plane. Okay, this plane is all made of wood. So we know the strength of this material. And what's the area? The area is this area. A is this area. What's this? 0.7. Oh, 7? A. So this length here is A sine or cosine, the 45 degree. So this one, see the A now, this is 90 degree, right? And this is A. So this one and this one here, they are A sine, cosine. So this is A cosine, which is 1 over square root of 2 over 0.707. So this failure plane is A times 0.707 times L, the length. If you have a special length, you can calculate the strength. Or if you are designing the length, then you have the ultimate load, and the only thing required is what's L? What's the length L? You can calculate there 1 inch length, and then calculate okay, look, everything is shear failure. The failure is shear failure. Now, if the weld is loaded in tension or in compression, the failure will be shear failure, which is tensile failure. So the welds, they are failed in tension member or compression member, they fail in shear. Shear. Good? Which is, when you say shear, it is a tension failure. This attention or tensile stresses, tensile shear stresses. So, and the strength of the weld is FW, okay, which is the strength of the weld, the design strength or the allowable strength of that weld, times, this is the area. This is Rm. We don't design for Rm. The design strength of this weld is VRm. Rm is the nominal strength of the weld. So there is a V factor, how much? 0.7. So 0.7 times this thing here, FW, 0.707, A times LW. Good? So this is the A in shear. So this is the opposite, FW. Okay? Strength in shear. Remember, when we said there's tensile strength and there's shear strength. Both are tension. يعني تكسر اذا بتمسك بار تفحص التنشن اعطيك افواي اذا بتفحص البار او بليت ان شير it is still silent but it doesn't give you افواي usually 1/6 افواي and you will see this is what we will take care of. This is what we will take. This will be 0.6 times the strength of the weld. Yeah, this is 70, this is 0.6 times 70. Okay? These are the grades we covered them. We have grade 60, 70. This is how we designate them. What is the designation? Here. If you have 70, you refer to E70XX, that means the tensile or the strength of the weld material is 70 psi. All of these are in psi. And what to use? They are telling you the yield stress of the base metal you are welding, which is the member, usually the member, is between 60 and 65 psi, use 70. If it's more than 65 psi, use 80. In between, either this or this. You can end at 60. This or this. 65. This or this. More than 65. This. This than 60. This. This is how you read this one. The overlap, either this or this. Okay? It's optional. And FW is 0.6 times the strength of the weld. So now we have the formula. Okay? So the strength is 175 times 0.6 times 70. This is phi FW. This is FW. And this is the phi factor. 0.75. So the strength will be phi times this times the area, which is 0.707 A times L. Good. Again, also, not only when you design a welded connection, you need to calculate the strength of the weld and the strength of the base metal, the material you are welding. You don't want also this to control the design strength, which is stated here. The base metal area can fail by shear yielding or rupture. Yeah, when you test the weld, okay, you have a plate, which is under a plate or a member, and you weld them together. Then you test it. Either the weld will break with 45 degrees, or the base metal will break in two limit state or two failure modes. One of them is shear failure, shear yielding, and the other one is shear rupture. And for shear yielding limit state or failure mode, the strength is, this is the base metal. See, this is for the base metal, not the weld. The weld, we covered it. The base metal. 1, the phi factor is 1, times 1/6 of y times the gross area of base metal, subjected to shear. For shear rupture, phi r unequal 0.75 times 1/6 fw, fu here, f ultimate. Times net area of base metal subjected to shear. Sometimes, في ناس بلحموا وبتركوا area. Not all of the base metal is connected. There's net. But most of the time is the same. If you have net area, you calculate the net area. If there's above a hole or something like that. Well, FW, FYN, these are the yield and ultimate strength of that base metal, which is again, most of the time is the member. Base metal is the member you are welding. Now, here. This is the limit state for shear yielding of the base metal. 175, this is the weld. So when we evaluate something, this is the weld. We cover. And this is the base metal. The weld has one strength. 175, 1.7 times A under E. What's this one? 0.6 F of the weld. Or the base metal. The base metal has two limit states. This is the shear yielding, and this is the rupture. Shear rupture. So 1.6 Fy times T times Lw, and this one, 0.75 times 1.6 Fu times T times Lw. This is the length of the weld, this is the thickness of the base metal. Yeah, the design strength of this welded thing is either this, or this, or this. Two limit states from the base metal, one limit state from the weld. The lesser controls the strength of the connection. The lesser control the strength. You have to check the three of them. Good? These are geometric limitations, not strength limitations. These are geometric limitations. To accommodate things. size a minimum. What's the thickness of the web? A minimum is function of the thickness of the thickest connected plate. يعني we check what's the thickness of the thickest connected plate. يعني what do you mean connected plate? يعني الوايد فلانج في thickness للويب مرات وفي thickness لل فلانج. It depends on what thing you are welding. Okay. I busted this table. Did you see it?
Yes.
I busted this table. يعني very simple table. If the thickness of the plate this and that, use the wood like this one. I posted this one on the website just today in the morning. You have very easy to select. Good? Asra, we will apply to the exam in a minute. Given in this table, which I posted, very simple table. Maximum size is a function of the thickness of the thinnest plate. And this function of the thickness of the thickest is the function of the thinnest of the thinnest. Last one. Along edges of plates with thickness this or equal 0.25, and if there's plates with thickness less than 0.25, A max is 0.25. If there's plates with the thickness is greater than this one, A max, the maximum A is T minus 1 over 60 inch. And which one you pick, A minimum or A max? In between, you are allowed to pick one. In between, and if you select A minimum and you are allowed to select higher, you will have higher length. If you select the maximum, you will have shorter length of the weld because all will affect the design.
So let's be higher and let's be had that.
Limit. You know, has a little cost. And sometimes you don't have enough length. Sometimes you don't have enough length. Yeah, remember that if the plate just 5 inch less. So the length for the welding, if you want to weld, is just maybe 5 from here and 5 from here. So you go with the maximum. Sometimes you don't have the maximum. But it's allowed to use this one, this one. Sometimes the cost. Minimum length now. This is for the minimum thickness, which is A. And this is the minimum length. What's the minimum length? LW always must be greater than 4A. Always must be greater than 4A. And if A is 1.25 inch, if A is 1.25, 1. Minimum. Otherwise, A effective, otherwise, this is not the case, you have to calculate A effective from LW, the actual length divided by 4, not LW. Intermediate fillet welds LW minimum 4A and 1.5. Maximum effective length, this is the most important thing. If LW get this than 100, what do you take L to calculate the strength? If L this than 100A, what does it mean? And if L over A is this than 100, the thickness in the calculation is the full L. If the thickness of the weld is 1/2 inch, then you are using weld 1/2 inch. Okay? L and the length is 50. Right? The length. You are welding 50-inch long weld. 50-inch long weld. So LW less than 100 times, which is 50. In your calculation, you calculate, and when you calculate the strength of the weld, which is multiplied by L, right? You take the full L. But if you are welding for 1/2 inch, you are welding 60 inch, yani the length of your weld is 60 inch, for 1/2 inch thick, look, this is 100 times 1/2 is 50, right? You are welding 60. So this is not your case. What's your case is this one. It's this one, which is 60 less than 150, right? This is 1/2 inch, this is 150. So 60 is, you are in this category. So the length of the weld you take in your calculation is LW, which is the 60, 1.2 minus 0.02, LW, which is 60, divided by A. You use this equation. Most of the equations are here. This is your case. Now, this is, you need to check. And when you start the problem, you have to check the minimum and maximum A, and you have to check L. Because this would be your case maybe. يعني L ما تستخدم كله. ممكن something smaller than L. If you use the full L, like I showed you here, then you are overestimating the strength of the weld. You are not meeting the code. If this is the case, which is rare situations, look, you take only 0.6 L. Only 0.6 L. Good? This is the case. Yeah, the thickness is 0.25. A is 5 inch and you are welding 100 inch. Okay? So you take
6
new calculations. When you calculate the strength, you don't take the full 100, you only take 60 new calculations. The 40 is lost. The 40, the extra 40, you lost them because you have a bad design. Unless you have to, unless you cannot use more than the quarter. If this is the case, what you do? You increase the thickness of the weld. Okay? So these are size limitation on the weld, the thickness and the length of the weld. Let's go over this example. Determine the design strength of the tension member and induction shoulder. Remember in the previous, in the first chapter, we calculated the design strength of the tension member. We said, okay, there is yielding and there is fracture, and we know how to take care of it. Right? The only hard thing one is what's air effective, which is U times AN. Here when you have weld, AN is A gross. The only thing you need to calculate is U. We have three cases, you can calculate U. Good? So you can calculate the strength of the number. The number is given to you. I play it 4 by 3/8 of an inch. You have, should have FY and you should have F ultimate, and you can calculate it easily. Now what's the, is this weld good or not? So he's welding this plate to this gusset plate. 5 inch here, then there's a return here on 1/2 inch and 1/2 inch here. And the thickness of the plate is 3/8, and the thickness of the gusset plate is 1/5 inch. Good? Now, look, always when you have a return, if you return here, yani around the corner, or you want to stop it before you return, it must be at a distance greater than 2/8. Or if you want to return, you must return at least a distance of 2a. يعني ما في واحد يجي يستخدم هنا 1.25. بس you are not meeting the code requirement. The code says if you want to return here, you have to go 2a, and your a is 1.25. Or say it's okay if you want to stop it here. You cannot stop it at the end here. You have to stop it a distance at least 2a before this one, 1/2 inch before this one. Is it 1 year or
one?
Where?
For this one.
Where? At least A?
When did the joint fillet turn out at a distance greater than A?
Yeah, you are right. So A, at least A from this. If you again, if you want to start it here, you have to start at least a distance A. Yani quarter. Now, this one you can take care of it. Yani you can consider it in your calculation as 1 inch long. And you can add it to your calculation, or you say, keep it, pause. And your calculation of the strength of this one, you can consider 5 and 5. Or if you are really, really tight and you need some more, you can consider that it is 11. And you can calculate this one 11. Yeah, if I am the one who's doing this one, I will do it all around. Again, if the welder is there, let him finish the welding. Why you do it this way? Just weld all around. It's the man hour cost. The cost is for the welder. Yeah, the material cost is not a big deal. The cost is to bring a guy, this is the cost. But since he is there, let him finish the weld. So you need a lot of like cranes, like study about the system, you have a lot of safety things, a lot of tools. But if he is there and right there, he can finish the weld. How much time does it take you to finish this?
So this table, direct, straightforward. They're saying the material thickness of the thinner part joint and minimum thickness size of the fillet welds. Says up to 1/4 inch, use 1/8 inch. Says between 1/4 and 1/2 inch, use 3/16 inch. Our member is in this category, between 1/4 and 1/2 inch. So the minimum is 3/16 inch.
That's the case over there. So our member, the 3/8 inch is between second one. So the minimum is, this is the minimum. You can't use something less than this. What's the maximum now? A max from the formula in the specification is that this one minus 1/8 inch. This is the formula. There is a formula in the specification. Okay? This is the A max. A max. This max you only take 1/16 inch. 5/16. See, you are allowed 3/16 or 5/16. You can go with this or this. It's up to you. He decided to go with something in between, which is 4/16, which is 12. And you can go with 5/16, no problem. Or this. Both are allowed. So A is, but he's giving you, by the way. Yeah, this one is a checking problem. This is analysis. Is this good or not? Yes, the 1/4 is in between. If you are designing, you can go with this or this. But for checking, this is good, in between. So good. Minimum 1 inch, we have more than 1 inch. Which is 4A, right? Minimum, there is 4A. And there is another limitation on the 4A should be, this is a limitation. It's not stated in the slide, but this is a limitation. You have to check it. The minimum length is LW. Minimum is the transverse distance between the waves. The transverse distance. This is the transverse distance here, which is the thickness of the blade. So that is the minimum length of the wave must be at least this one here, which is 4 inch. So we are good. We have 10 or 11. Minimum length. So on each side, sorry, on each side. Each one should be at least a transverse distance. So that's 5 greater than 4, we are good. Length, now what's the length? We need to check L over A. If it's L from 100, we take the full length. So L over A is 5 over 0.25, which is equal to 20, less than 100. So you take the full length. When you do the calculation, you base the calculation on all of this one. And the two-way, the end return is 0.5, good. So geometric wise, everything is good. Is it good to carry the load? How we calculate that? We don't have a load. We have a load. How we calculate this thing? The strength of the member. The strength of the member. The strength of the weld must be at least the strength of the member. Must be at least the strength of the member or more than that. So if you go to the table, this is the strength of the weld. 3.78.6 × 70 we have times the length. So 175 times that, this is 0.6 × 70. And this is 10. See, he's basing his calculation based on 10. You can use 11 if you want. You can use 11. So he has 55.67. So the weld strength is 55.67 hips. Now in this metal we have two limit states, free yielding or rupture. One times 0.6 times 50 times this one. By the way, this one is not stated. Usually for plates, what material we use for plates? We use A992. 836. Usually we use 836. And this one should be given to you. He's using 50 and 65. This is either he's giving you this one, this is the material, or it should be given to you. Yeah, usually this is 36 and this is 58 for 836. If that's the case, I think it still would be good. And why this is high? Because he's using 50. Again, this information should be provided to you. 50 or this one. Good? Good. Okay? This is more than the wind, so everything is good. So what's the strength of the tension member? 0.9 Fy A gross. 67.5. A effective. You can go with the table and check what's the applicable one. He's using 175. Then 54.8, that's for the tension number. So you see the tension number strength is less than the wind strength. When we use 10, and you still can adjust this one to 11/10 times this number. maximum tension number. First, design the equal weld for this tension number. You need to design it. Okay. يعني هيرجع لك tension number على فاين. بكل شيء، that's everything. Okay. Like this design problem. Like this design problem. You have design a double angle tension member and connection system to carry a factor load of 250 kg. So it's P out equal to 250. Assume 36 KSI and use E60, E70. I will give you this thing. This information will be given to you. Then this is what we have. So two, if you go to the table, you need to select double angle with a strength, either in yielding or fracture, more than 250, more than. So he's selecting from the table 2L5 by 3.5 by half, right from A36. So this one here in the table is based on what? And we select this one from the table directly. It's based on the fracture is the AE is 0.75 A gross. Now remember, in welded connections, usually this is true. It's very easy. In welded connections, because A gross is AM. In bolted connections, you may have A effective less than 0.75. Okay? Why? Because there is AN and there is a U factor. Okay? In welded connection, most probably, you will be okay. Why? Because you have A gross equal AN. Now, the U factor, how much? The minimum U factor is how much? 0.75. So you are fine. So the value you have there for the rupture is good. Okay? So he selected this angle here. So the thickness of the selected member is half inch. The thickness of the selected member is half inch. So this is A minimum, this is A max, and he's using 3/8 of an inch in between, value in between, which is 1375. Now the strength of the weld per inch. See, this is the strength per inch, or per LW. And LW is the one we need to calculate. Once times this one, so we get 8.35 LW. We go to the base metal, it's also a function of LW. He has 10.8 LW and 13.05 LW. Yeah, this strength will give you 10.8 times whatever length you use. This will give you 13.05 times that. And this will give you 8.35 pattern. So this one controls the design. This controls the design. Now this one should be equal for design, equal to P ultimate, 250. Not the true form we are designing based on 250. Not the strength of the tension number, plus than 260 and 261. Tension number is good, but we are designing for 250. Okay? If I don't give you the 250, you design for the 260 to make sure the strength of the weld more than the strength of the tension member. Good? Based on that, you can calculate the length. So the length should be at least 29.94. You can go with 30 or 36 or at least 30. At least 30. So that's the design. Now, this one is just how you arrange it. Remember, double angle. We have double angle. Remember, two faces. One angle from one side, one angle from another side, and you have length in the middle. Here. So remember, the length of the weld will be twice. Yeah, you will need 15 per angle. Well, what is the weld? It's going to be here and here. In horn, on horn, on horn. This is what you have to do. And you see this one, if you use this configuration, and you have these options. Either this, or this, or this. If you will go around, what's this height here? Is the angle you selected. What's this one here? What's the angle? 5, right? Yeah, for this configuration, this is 5. How much you need, is it?
Sure.
30, from this side. How much?
15.
15, and from the, 15 for this side, and 15 for the other side. That's 5. What's left here and here?
5.
10 total, 5 and 5. Good? This one? This is this. This one is this line here. This one here is this line here. This is if you cut it develop from this. This one is how much? This one, all the way here. 5, right? And this one is? Okay, let's just go back to the first one. First one, if you use this option here.
Which one? The other one is the rounding or U factor is small.
Yeah, by the way, each one gives you a U factor. Each one gives you a U factor. Different U factor, and that's why I like to do it all around. The U factor will not be one, remember? Why? Because not all legs are welded. And this one is not welded, see? So there's no efficiency. This leg of the angle is not welded. The U is not one, but it's
higher value.
This or this. Again, if you stop here, you have to stop at this A. So this is 15, this should be 7.5 and 7.5. If you go here, for this option here, you go 2A here and 2A here, you have our weight is quarter or what?
Just about.
Quarter or more? 3/8 of an inch. Do you know the size? 3/8 of an inch. Again, you take this one you subtract it from 15, and this one's 21. For this one, again, you need 15. I don't know why you're using 5.75. This one is.
Oh, sit down.
This one is 5.75, and this one is 5.75, and this one is 5. We just need 15. Okay, this one is maybe it can go with 5. Can go with 5. Okay. The last subject. Again, you can arrange this one. Calculate the U and check again. Everything should be fine. And the last thing is something called designation of the weld. This is for the welder. These are for the welder. On the plan, we show this one. They read them. They know how to read these things. Like here. This means if this triangle here, which is the weld, this means the weld, shape of the weld. This is the thickness. I'm telling him 1/4 inch, length 6 inch, or 7, rubber, thickness, where? The near side. If this one is from here, it means from your side. If you're telling him here, you're telling him from the other side. Again, this is 1/4 thickness, length 6, then you get 10 from the other side. Here, both sides. Here, all around. All around with this thickness. Here, it's just another way for showing what the strength of the weld. Yeah, it's definitely E70. Here, when you have the flag, tell him this in the field. Amrat will have him shop. They will everything and they transfer them to the